Hello everyone, and welcome back to Laurence Plays Factorio Space Expansion. I think everything's actually going quite well today. I have very few things to complain about. So in the last episode, do you remember I set up the science construction down here and had these science factories up here? They're all now finished and working except for modules. So they're running quite well. As you can see, we've got a nice steady stream of pink, blue, red and yellow science going into these, even though there are some alien artifacts scooped up along there, but I'll worry about those if they ever make it through. And I've got another one of them over here. So we're now up to a total of, I think, five of these it must be, because there's one here, two here, and then one down here. So we're running through science at 5 times 25 per second, so 125 a second of each one. That's quite a lot. No wonder I seem to be getting through things fairly quickly. I'm also on to faster than light theory D research as well, so that's going quite well. I've got 3 of them done now, and they're just getting faster and faster, at least until I start to run out of science packs. So at the moment, yeah, there's plenty in here. This one, the red seems to be getting a bit low, but yeah, that should be summoning a new train to refill it fairly soon. We'll see if that actually works. Over here, things look generally okay. Now, let's see, how are we doing down here? How is the research, the building of the packs going? So 171,000 in that one, 79,000 in that one. So that one, it's getting through them pretty quickly. I'm not sure whether that's at 79,000 because that's as high as it's got, or whether it got much higher and is now coming back down again. We'll have to keep an eye on it and see how it goes. Grey, I don't care about. Blue, how's blue doing? Blue is at 56,000. Again, I don't know whether that's on the way up or down. Purple's full. Pink is 109,000, so that's doing well as well. The pink is being less of a problem than I feared, and green is, of course, full because we're not using those. Up top, let's see how these are doing as well. 192 there. 48 there. Now, no, it wasn't that one. It was the, again, I don't care about grey. Blue is 47, that's not brilliant. That's gone down a long way. I think I'm going to run out of blue science fairly soon, and I'm going to need to go and work out why. The inputs all seem to be full. The red circuit is a bit limited. Oh, there's some... Okay, that's interesting. Let's fix that. So, it looks like... I know what will have happened here. I'll have come along, set all of this to be upgraded to green belts, and then gone, oh look, I need to have the sort of the thing on here to filter on, make sure both sides of the belt are filled, and built that up, and forgot to then set it to be upgraded again. So, yeah, so the red circuits aren't coming through as fast as they should. Maybe that'll help a bit. Although that said, I'm doubtful, because these are all, nearly all, running flat out. I think I need to put in some more blue science assembly machines on the top of here. Purple's fine, of course. Pink is... Oh dear, I've left my train in the way. Always the case. Let's get that out of the way. Pink is 117,000. Yeah, that's pretty good. That's doing well. Can ignore that for now. And green over here we can ignore as well. Okay. So, we seem to have decent amount of science being constructed. Blue is a little bit low. I think I want to go and put in some more, maybe another one or two of these sort of racks of assembly machines. That hasn't helped as much as I hoped it would. We're down to, yeah, that should be getting a new supply of red circuits soon. There have been a few other things I've had to fiddle with. I'm sure there was something over here. Maybe that was the previous episode. Oh yes, I needed some new mines. So I put in a new Jeevalite, not Jeevalite mine, a new Styrotite mine up here, because I'd completely eaten up the previous one, so that was needed, and obviously that's now completely full. Got loads and loads of Styrotite available there, and a Sapphirite one. Yes, the Sapphirite one there, which I don't strictly need it, but it was for filling up this station down here, because I got a bit fed up of the alerts popping up all the time, even though that is actually technically being filled from the mine down here. So I thought I'd just put that in so I wouldn't get so many alerts. How's it going otherwise? So we've got... Okay, so we're out of white science. Transport and logistic science packs. I'm not 100% certain which those are. I'll need to check that. Electronic circuit boards. I thought I'd fixed that. Let's have a look. Is that... It's these ones, isn't it? Yeah, there's 86,000 of those. There must have just been two trains trying to go there at the same time, and that's why it complained. Because that's absolutely fine. Red circuits, red circuits have stopped. Why have red circuits stopped? It's not because we've run out of copper this time. It's this red. Interesting, the ferric chloride has run out. What's produced that? It's this, whatever this one is. Iron ore, but for some reason. Right, we've had a. It looks to me like somehow this under the underground belt has only been half upgraded. So if I do this, that should fix it. I'm just hoping I wasn't trying to push something else up here and I've messed it up by changing them around. There we go, now that's working again. Pour that in there. Right, so that'll get that working again, which will get my my red circuits running again. So generally, yes, things are going well. I mean, there's still an enormous quantity of research to do. I'm a third of the way through D, and there's still D1, D2, and E, I suppose, even if it isn't called that, left to do. So I'm doing the pink one, then there's the purple one, then the green one, then the absolutely everything one. So yeah, lots to do, lots to do, but I think I'm very much on the home stretch now. The base is working. I've not even needed to put out more solar panels for a while. Everything is just ticking over, and yeah, I can improve the efficiency of all of this with the productivity modules as they get produced, except they're not an old tier that's broken as well. Should we have a look into that? No, it's started working again. I suspect what probably happened was we ran out of the crystals. That's usually the problem. Even if there's 1,100 of them, that's quite a lot. Maybe I ran out. No, it's the ferric chloride here as well. So that ran out up here as well. So I couldn't produce these boards anymore. So that's solved. We don't need to worry about that too much. So 1,100 means I'll be able to produce about 45 of them, and I still need 1,700. So it's a slow process. I suspect I might have finished all of the research by the time all of those productivity modules are finished, but never mind. I kind of don't care. Whilst I do sort of want to go down and fill all of these up with productivity modules manually, I think I might do that just to save on the resources. The research labs, it doesn't matter so much. Yes, it would make things a bit faster if I used them there, but yeah, never mind. It's not that big a deal. So, everything's going well. I think I'm on the home straight now, as I said. And it's just a case of leaving it ticking over until absolutely everything's done and I can get away from this planet, I suppose. Then I'll have to decide what I want to do for my next playthrough. I'm thinking I'll probably have a look at space exploration. That's different to space expansion. That's the one that involves building rockets and going off to different planets because they have different resources available on them. So, we'll see how that goes. But I think, as I say, I shall finish this one off first and then start looking at the next playthrough. Or maybe, you never know, maybe I'll play something else other than Factorio, but nobody seems to care about my videos and for anything else, so I think Factorio is the way to go. I'll see you next time for the next one, and as always, thanks for watching.